in the playoffs.
That's interesting. The Team Impulse curse so far has been 4 wins, 5 losses in the first half of the split, then go 7-2 in the back half. Well, they've got 7-0 in the back half, and now with the substituted for the mid lane.
But by the way, these bans that were instantly put up there are not correct. I think those may be from a previous game.
Yeah.
The actual bans here from Gravity is Twisted Fate and Kog'Maw first, whereas Impulse have answered Ryze and Kalista so far. Mm-hmm. I do expect Nidalee to find her way somewhere onto the bans.
Nidalee, but Lee Sin got banned by Gravity, so.
Yeah. So these are now the correct bans you guys see on your screen. I'm either expecting a ban by Team Impulse for Nidalee, which will put Rush in a tough spot, or they give Nidalee over, which I'd imagine, just based on the priority and the success both Move and Rush have had on it, would be first pick worthy.
That's interesting because, of course, it's always been Apollo gets Sivir. Oh, no, you can really let that happen. And Adrian gets Alistar. Fizz is actually the final ban here for Team Impulse. So, yeah, this sets up the Sivir versus Nidalee and Alistar, I think, trifecta. Yeah.
They've got a mid laner named Gate now. And Twisted Fate is pretty good into
this
Nidalee.
Is best champion.
Just to run over the bans one more time, it was Twisted Fate, Kog'Maw, and Lee Sin for Gravity. And for Team Impulse, it was Ryze, Kalista, and Fizz. But as we expected, the first pick Nidalee.
All right, so Move gets his signature champion for this split, and Rush will have to once again go down in the tier list. Yes, Apollo does get his Sivir, and actually Shen prioritized over the Alistar here. We'll see if that ends up being Impact or Adrian.
I mean, you're going to give away the Nidalee here as Impulse, but you get so many of the tools that they used so successfully in previous weeks. Already, the Sivir is a crucial part to the way Impulse like to play. Their high-tempo style, when combined with global teleports, it really enables Rush to have success with his very aggressive early play style. They can tack Twisted Fate on top of all of this and top it off with another global as well, if they so choose.
That one's unfortunately banned, so...
Pantheon, I've seen the bans, so distracting.
I know, it's unfortunate. We'll rally them off again a little bit later, but the Lucian once again comes through here. I mean, the curse had been broken. Lucian's already won a couple of games in a row, so now he's just reversing in the back half of the split, and Altec's going to go for that one, interestingly, too, because there's really only 2 AD carries off the table. He wants one for himself. The Maokai in for Haunter is going to happily play a tank up there. And I know you mentioned this in game one, Jat. Nidalee and Maokai, fun to have a combo together.
Yeah, tremendous synergy. High damage jungler, super tank top laner. I'm really wondering what direction Team Impulse is going to go for in the jungle as well as in the mid lane, because they almost want to lock in their jungler now and save Gate for a for sure last pick, just knowing Keen's versatility.
Yeah, I tend to agree. They're hoping on the Alistar in there. Yeah, okay, so Evelynn in for Rush. We have been seeing mostly Runeglaive in a tank for that champion, but we'll see what Rush's take on it. He tends to be more aggressive than most others. We do have it for sure, top lane Shen, in for Impact up there with the support Alistar.
Yeah, Runeglaive is all around the best choice for Eve now that we are. It has been buffed, 10 extra AP as well as increasing the active damage. So definitely going to have some early moves here from Rush, and that kind of affects the entire mentality of the Gravity team and all of their lanes. For the entirety of the time where they can't keep track of Rush. So we'll see how well Move can do with his deep wards, because while he focuses a lot on wards, he's going to have to alter the placement a little bit here against Evelynn, go deeper into the actual camps, as well as make some pink ward trips and try and get some good traps as in the brush that he thinks that he will move through.
This is interesting. So Keen has gone with Orianna typically when he can't do his last pick move. Obviously, Gravity, more dangerous team on the red side, so they can use Keen's really strange champion pool to last pick counters. But this is a kind of protect the Altec team composition, which has been successful in the past on Lucian. He does very well with some shields. And it's a bit of a buff up the Altec strategy with a highly mobile AD carry instead of one who cannot dodge Shenton. So that'll be interesting to see if Gravity can pull this off.
Yeah.
I really think that they are going to look for the 2v2 also. I think that is important for Gravity. They want to try and find the standard lanes here. So we'll see if Impulse actually look for a lane swap. Lucian and Janna into Sivir Alistar should be good for them.
Very true. We'll see if that ends up being the case for them. The lanes come through that way. We'll see how much carry damage can come through. The last choice to come through for Impulse, and Gate making his LCS mid lane debut. Going to have Azir for himself. Seems like Gravity didn't want to ban any of his champions away that weren't named Twisted Fate, and so he gets the Emperor of Shurima for himself. Once again, 513, so prior to all the changes to how his attack speed scales up and whatnot, but...
Xiao only played one Azir game during the regular season. It was a defeat to Team Soulmid in Week 2, so this is somewhat of a new look for Team Impulse, and I'm really wondering if this team is going to be vastly worse without Xiao, or if they're going to be able to pick up where they left off. Adrian back on support, just need a good mechanical mid laner, and it's on Gate to step up to the pressure.
You know, one thing this does help is it removes one of the languages that Team Impulse has to speak in the game. Not the strongest in English. I know Rush still has to kind of bounce between English and Korean for impact's sake, but it actually might buff the coordination of the team in some way here if we're to look at maybe the optimistic case here for Impulse.
Well, we will have to see. The other thing that's interesting here is, yes, Keen is on Orianna. He, just at the last second, swaps the smite away for a heal. And he's not going to go with the Runeglaive Orianna build, more standard.
All right, so standard stuff here, but we want to know how you guys think this game's going to go online. Send hashtag GVWin or hashtag TIPWin, and we will tally up the vote once you're in-game. Gravity looking for a hold on that first place spot. Impulse looking to make it 8 wins in a row and dethroning the number one team here in North America. Getting ourselves into the game. We're in the last week of regular LCS action right before we gear up for the playoffs and Worlds, and these are two of the front runners.
So early on, we got to track whether or not we get a lane swap or standard lanes, because North American LCS has been very lane swap happy lately. Everyone buying into that game.
Yeah, and we'll see if these teams can improve on their way towards the postseason, because Gravity have actually kept their focus on playoffs all year long and see it as the true proving grounds for how good the team really is.
MSG was like pretty much our main goal from the beginning of the season. We didn't really, it's not like, we're going to Worlds. It was MSG. And then now that we can control our own destiny for the first seed, it's like, it'll prove how good we are, I guess.
Yeah, well, so far in the regular season, it's looked good for you guys. But yeah, best of fives are always very different. Adapting to your team is a very important skill in major competition. Gravity, to my knowledge, are 1-3 in best of fives. They actually lost to Impulse themselves in it.
Much different team.
Of course, a different team at a different time, but...
Yeah, two players changed out. Minions have spawned. Also, I'm pretty sure they would have won a best of five to make it into the LCS.
I suppose you're right. But back then they were Curse Academy, so...
Different times.
Depends if you count it.
Different name, different players as well for some of them.
Yeah, last game these guys played was incredibly close as well.
So the default setup is the what we expect to be now the standard double jungle here.
So it looks like Gravity are not going to find 2v2 as they send their duo top here. Lucian and Janna are just going to head over to the lane without doing a camp, whereas Impulse looks like they did do the gromp with their duo. And Alistar will try and roam early.
Yeah, this could end up backfiring onto Gravity because their jungle will be going towards the weak side of the map.
This is actually a really good plan here for Impulse. They give all the experience for the Gromp over to Alistar, who is very ineffective at level 1. But once you get that combo, you unlock so much roaming power with Alistar. The only problem is he's not going to find anybody to use it on. So.
This is strange. I feel like Adrian should be sticking around, not necessarily recalling, because he would want to harass jungle later. But that's not even what's going to be happening. Gravity, they're no way are they going to be able to control all their buffs, so they're going right for a dive.
This is interesting, yeah. So Impact is staying up in the top lane, but Evelynn's leaving him alone, whereas the rest of Gravity's coming up here with only Alistar support. This is a small risk here.
At this point, Team Impulse should be calling for Impact to bail, or they should have their support there already, because once Alistar goes in the jungle,
they're
he knows
the
where
way.
The start would have been. Let's see if they can pull off the turret dive.
No.
Already a poor start.
Wow, Bunny burns Ignite with no one around.
That was definitely some miscommunication on Gravity's part. Bunny started tanking, and they only half-heartedly went for the dive. Now they end up with a poor mission, and that is huge. No teleport. They lose out on a tremendous amount of experience down bottom. Apollo gets free damage on the turret, and this minion wave will go to waste. Haunter is going to be very, very far behind this game. What a big play from 8.
One more javelin. Not quite going to land him. Should have aimed a bit farther left.
I don't think it would have killed him either.
Still had the Clash to spare.
Yeah.
But really, that early opening right there, Gravity had a small window to take advantage, but they were kind of outgamed at the start of it when they started on the strong side and would not have been able to rotate down to the other side of the jungle, so they would have been denied. They gamble for the dive. They can't pull off the turret dive. Team Impulse was late on the rotation, but then because they saved the dive and also disrupted the teleport from Haunster means they can get a couple of big edges.
Yeah, Adrian back on the squad and already making huge plays for the team. Using that combo on Alistar to get his advantage.
Move realizes red buff is gone. Nice invade by Adrian Rush together. Takes away a small piece of the red buff, but Impulse getting a large portion of the jungle, and the third buff is just waiting for them in this right-hand side of the map, so much better jungle start.
Yeah. And really, the main power discrepancy here is between Impact and Haunster because of that interrupted teleport. Everyone else has been able to farm pretty standardly.
And now we get to watch the matchups here. Haunster and Bunny Fufu laning together. Janna Maokai does not seem like the strongest duo, and in fact, Apollo and Adrian have the makings of a lane freeze as well. Haunster may be held even farther down, as Shen should be fine one-on-one-ing Altec up there in the top lane.
And it looks like they are calling a swap here now. So they're going to bring Lucian down to meet up with Janna, and they are going to send Haunster to the 1v1 with Impact. Now, Impact does have the minion wave in front of his turret at the moment, but it will be pushing back out eventually. So Haunster will not have to deal with a freeze. Yeah. It'll be up to jungler intervention here for any more action. Basically, the big thing that comes of this early game is that Impact has the ability to make a teleport play right now, while they also have the timer on Haunster's teleport cooldown.
Multiple teleport plays, because he's going to be hitting level 6 very early on here. And for a time, Gravity kind of had a free farm lane for Altec. They could have left Altec up against Impact Shen and just farmed that one out. But now they're kind of swapping into some disadvantageous moves because Apollo has a level advantage on Altec and Impact will have a level advantage on Haunster, yet those will be the lanes. Team Impulse definitely an opportunity to pull ahead here.
Yeah, pretty much all of the gold lead is on Impact for Team Impulse. I would expect Team Impulse to be able to get an early dragon really easily, if not something more. If not, you know, a teleport play down bottom for some kills.
As soon as Impact hits level 6, expect a play from Team Impulse if they're on their game.
And they would have got this back at the bot lane with the pickaxe in tow for Sivir to keep the matchup equal. Adrian pretty much has all his offensive tools already. He's past level 2, so congratulations. Flash Pulverize exists for you. And
yeah.
Good luck, Bunny and Altec, for peeling away from it. Only level 4 on Janna, so no knockback for a while.
Rush must just have something against upgrading his jungle item early, because he does this with Lee Sin as well. He'll build his Brutalizer to just go with his Hunter's Machete. Here he builds his Sheen straight off the bat for more combat power. He gains less gold from the jungle, 15 less per camp, without upgrading first to either, you know, the Chilling Smite or the Ranger's Trailblazer, whichever one he decides to go for.
He is all about combat effectiveness.
Don't give me combat stats. Doesn't want them.
All right. Even those combats with the jungle, and those upgrades do give him jungle combat.
He's got a stuff. Fight freak.
All right, great. Well, if he ever ganks, then congratulations. If he doesn't, then I think it's just kind of silly. But either way, Impact is battling Haunster. It's actually a bit of a level mismatch for now, 6 versus 5. So that continues to be pretty important. A finished Spectre's Cowl also means it's impossible for Haunster to deal damage there. Keen gets his blue buff safely at 7 minutes. Gate will have to wait a while for his.
I'd say 30 seconds until Rush starts fighting somebody, Freak.
All right, here's a play down bottom. They've already tried, but they did it without the Shen ulti. They just went for the trade itself, and looks like with Adrian able to heal, they're happy to keep taking these fights. Did a damage in Altec.
It's just so safe right now for Adrian to go in and make aggressive headbutt pulverize moves, because if anything ends up getting turned around on them, they do have the Shen to at least grant a shield, and it could be interrupted for the teleport, but a lot of safety going on for them. Great ward here that could catch Rush.
You can kill a small one.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
He probably needed 15 gold for something.
He goes to 600 off that. We'll see how much he has in tow after finishing his final. I think he's actually 30 gold short of
I mean, it's only 450 to upgrade your smite.
He would have needed the whole wave. He sold his ward. It's probably going to wait a little while, then upgrade. Yep, there it is.
All right, so sells consumables for the upgrade. Meanwhile, Apollo and Adrian taking a bad trade. So back and forth, these guys really doing battle. Altec wanted the Lucian into the Sivir matchup, and a small CS lead as a result of it. a move waiting in the wings as well on a pink ward.
This is very dangerous for Move to actually try and do this. They would have to kill somebody before Impact can react. Hanzo's Teleport has come back off cooldown, but Shen will come in with the shield as well.
And this is interesting. Sivir's level 6, as is Evelynn, and Bunny Poopoo isn't yet. Adrian also can now tank a turret for like 12 seconds straight.
They could try a Brute Force 4-man gank if they really wanted to. They got to be a little bit suspicious with the way Adrian was right there, but you never know.
Oh, his dash is down for Altec.
They're going to flash headbutt. Oh, goodbye. Bunny Poopoo flashes away, but can he really make it out? Looks like the ulti from Rush is going to be enough. First blood comes through to the Team Impulse jungler.
Yep, and they hold on to all of Shen's teleports. See if they can transition this into anything. Move is headed already towards mid lane, though.
How about that spear?
He's going to get some autos. Not even autos. So, we're sitting 10 minutes into the game, and we have about an 11 minion discrepancy in the mid lane. Gate getting slightly out lane here. Not a gank in that spot, but Rush gets the ulti in from Impact. Here comes the push towards Keen. Keen does have flash, pops it, Impact's gonna go with the taunt flash. Gonna land out a big shockwave, but is it gonna be enough time?
Oh, Keen!
No! Oh, he flashes out! You gotta be kidding me! He makes it happen! 2-0 on Rush. Apollo spell shields, and in comes the rest of the fight. Now Adrian taking up with the ulti. Ignite is on him, but he's still walking away. Flames are not.
Oh, they're so low. Adrian's ult's down.
Move wants it. He gets it. Rush is dead. Adrian's going to go down too. The re-engage. The Emperor's Divide. Altec sequestered off. A double kill for Move. The fight continues. In comes the soldiers. It's so low, and he is going to die. Hanser gets one. 4-2. Impact, the last man standing. Will it be the ace? Pounce coming in. A big burst of damage. One more jump.
Oh, no!
You're kidding me. You are kidding me, and it goes overall 4-3 in the favor of Gravity.
Game of the week, boys!
That was a fight. Oh my goodness. So first off, Team Impulse goes incredibly aggressive and takes a bunch of damage, diving the second middle turret before the first one is down just to pick up the first kill. But meanwhile, there's a fight going down the bottom lane, so kind of the perfect storm of two simultaneous engages results in just a total bloodbath.
Rush did say Move's got a little bit of the same.
A little bit of rush in him.
Okay. Well, yeah, we're going to have to take another look at the entire fight, but Adrian's on the hunt once again. He doesn't have much damage here.
Yeah.
So just showing him who's boss.
All right. This was fun.
This is the beginning we all remember. Shen, yeah. The shield was taken off instantly there by Keen with his combo, but Impact wants to follow up with a flash of his own.
Yeah, and Keen, really good job getting the QW in there to just get Rush low. And this is the strange thing. Adrian and Apollo were also posturing for an aggressive move, which is why things went so poorly right here. Hans are doing a good job jumping in at the end there. And it's really the flank by move here that secures things for Gravity.
Yeah, he sits on the outside, throwing spears, flashes in for the kill here on Rush, who tried to dodge what he thought was going to be a spear, but move just went for the auto attack, empowered by that rune play, by the way.
Something that was really cute was Bunny Fufu's ultimate right after he got hit by the Emperor's Divide there, because it disallowed Gate from being able to follow up with any soldier auto attacks and saved a ton of health for Gravity in total. This, though...
This is where Move goes all Rush.
Yeah.
Tower hit at the same time. Passive there from Shen. Nobody expects the Shen burst, Jack.
It's true.
Yeah,
the turret
nice,
helped,
though. Yeah, sure, that's true. Well, Rush wants to mess with Haunter, just maybe. Dragon goes down. That's Gravity's first die of the game.
They also have Adrian coming in, too.
Impact has turret dagger, goes to the top after the root comes through. Well dodged, and that's going to be a kill picked up. Assist for Adrian thanks to the heal. And Impulse type skill, the kill's 4-4.
Yeah, they're going to trade the turrets, though. Altec down bottom, doing a lot of work.
Yeah.
Already finished off with that one, and he's going to try and shove all the way to secondary.
And Gate kind of out of position. He was doing a blue buff invade, but really, when you're pulling off a three-man dive like that, you need your mid laner in the mid lane to save this turret. It's going to end up being a 1-for-2 turret trade, maybe even 2-for-0.
Yeah, it's
and
pretty,
they don't have to steal the blue.
It is pretty hard, even as a Zeer, to defend against Nidalee, Janna, Orianna. So it is fairly dangerous, but probably could have delayed it there at least a little bit.
But Gravity's still pushing. I mean, this is characteristic good shot calling of Bunny Fufu. Bot lane turret nearly dead. They understand
tornado,
how much resources
interrupt.
They needed. A good shockwave, and they're going to go for Impact. Not going to do enough damage, though. Altec thinks the double shield will stay alive for this one. They're still going to push this turret down. Wow, three turrets picked up all at the same time.
Nice knock up there, interrupting the taunt from Shen. And Gravity are able to get two turrets out of it. plus they had got some damage on mid there.
I think they got mid, yeah. Beautiful stuff here. So, Gravity firing back with some nice plays, and now it's these guys with a 1,000 gold lead here. A hectic game, certainly, but plenty of smart choices being made.
Is Rush going to go full AP Elise with his three kills? He already has the Wind Wave. Sorcerer
no,
shoes.
He's not going to go full AP Elise. He may go full AP Evelynn.
You got me there. You got me there.
Yeah. But that's awesome. All right, we're going to get a full bursty Evelynn build here.
It's ridiculously powerful if you can hit your max items, but you almost never can do that in a competitive setting, especially with the team being behind like this.
And this is so very Rush, though. The first AP item that I usually get for AP Evelynn, though, is a Ludens Echo, because she moves so quickly with the constant W resets. That's a really effective item on her, and her AP ratios are not that great, so it's more about the extra bonuses from items and the passives that you can get. Oh. All right, let's see him at work here, though, with his spell penetration and blasting
wand. Can save, probably.
Well, do a little bit of damage. Nice top, but oh, nearly gets away with it all tech, and now suddenly Bunny Foofa's got nowhere to go. Oh, my gosh! He nearly put him into the javelin. Sheldy tries to save Rush. Rush is running and running and running, but not going to get away with this one. That's a kill traded back pretty cleanly. Impact. Gonna run for his life.
It was interesting that Bunny Fufu didn't use his Monsoon right at the start there, but turret push is going on.
Yep, the Gate and Apollo already took down the mid turret here, so four people committed top from Gravity. It is going to be a one for one, but mid lane still under attack.
And this is actually really smart then. Impulse managing to make some very good choice of their own. Great Demolitionist here with Gate playing Azir in the mid lane. Presses W. Unnecessary. It's true, though. He's probably the best turret mid laner not named Jace.
It is true.
Yeah, this game has really gotten crazy, though. There's a lot of objective trading being done after incredibly aggressive moves. Adrian does have his ultimate, but he is rather low.
Speaking of incredibly aggressive move.
Whoa!
Headbutts into move. Move wants to flash the wall. He is afraid of this one, but Rush here.
Rush, what are you doing?
Rush says hello to Move. Move wanted a ward, but you can't ward for Evelynn. And yes, Abyssal Scepter Rush is going to be the build.
Hugely over-aggressive there by Move. Hugely. He had safety on the backside. He had no vision of who could possibly be on the other side. And he goes in for a late Alistar kill. He was trying to pull off a hero move, and he got rushed down.
Oh, man. This is getting hilarious. It's going to be the Abyssal Scepter for his first AP item. So I guess you can't qualify that as semi-defensive.
It's like the Nidalee builds. Right, you get the Abyssal Scepter first. By the way, it gives you a ton of clear speed, by the way, because the aura does affect jungle monsters. So negative 20 MR is a lot of bonus damage. It lets him farm ridiculously fast. Monster playing the wave clear game for now in the jungle. Probably not counts. Doesn't count as wave clear, I suppose. But we are at a 800 gold game 16 minutes in. After our first two games being fairly one-sided, this is Gravity and Impulse trading blow for blow. Turret kills are the same. Dragons and kills only one apart. You gotta see Dragon up a minute and a half. Neither top laner has summoner teleport, but Impact will have stand united, so a pretty important map movement ability available that Gravity cannot answer.
Yeah, and once again, that Shen Maokai matchup that we set up at the beginning of the match, it has gone the way we thought it would, with Impact having the lion's share, almost the entire 1,000 gold lead of Team Impulse in his pockets, which is very good for him. They need to have him be a strong split push presence and keep Maokai bottled up, because the ultimate for Shen will come off cooldown quicker than Maokai's teleport. Oh, and the interrupt from Bunny is not enough.
Overrez comes through in time, nicely picked up. And yeah, it's going to look bad. So Altec will respawn in time for Dragon, but Impulse able to find these solo plays off the Evelynn pushes.
Yeah, Rush is getting rather powerful, and his ganks have led to a lot of powerful plays by Team Impulse. Now they're going to want to try and push this secondary turret. They could get assistance from Shen Ultimate, but this seems like a little bit of a futile.
So no attempt there. Wave cleared, all is well.
I think that Rush also benefits from Impulse having a strong Shen on their team, because he does not want to fight a Maokai. He doesn't want to get into a teamfight scenario where Hanser could lock him down, being very squishy on this Evelynn. Altec could take him out in a couple of crits. He does have magic resist, but very low armor here. Dragon being set up. Impact is ready to channel the Stand United, and
Hanser's in mid right there, so he's got to determine Does he play for Dragon? Does he play for top lane? Top lane tier 2 is alive, and Impact's going to reach it soon. They're both are smart. They take their time.
They're already down one Dragon, but obviously the second Dragon doesn't have that big of an influence over the game at this point. It would be nice to get the second one, but they can probably slow play this a little bit. Trading a turret for a Dragon would not be the worst thing.
Oh, it would be great for Team Impulse.
The question is, can they even get the turret?
Well, it looks like they're going to give it up the Dragon, and Maokai walking over to it means he's probably going to be able to stop Impact because he's full defense Shen here, all tank.
Unfortunately for Impulse then, they kind of let all the opportunities go away. They got some turret damage, they got some gold onto Impact, but a pretty clean Dragon 2 pickup as Rush just clears his jungle away, and even takes the red buff himself, didn't even go to Apollo.
Let's see if he transitions into some tanky items after.
I'm just waiting to see what Rush builds
because
next.
He could very well just go that Elise like build that you're looking for with a flat penetration and reduction, and then go tank build after that.
Warden's Mail is probably smart just because the majority of the damage will be coming from Altec in the late game, and he's already picked up a little bit of MR, so maybe a Frozen Heart will be his next item here.
Yeah, he's hitting about 100 armor, 100 magic resist. He's got shields from Shen potentially, so maybe that works out in his favor.
Shields from herself.
That's true as well, yeah. So, as you were talking about effective hit points earlier, Jat, the
lot of
resist
stack
good when you have shields, yeah.
I mean, resistances are great if you have shields or health.
Yep. He's got both. All right, Impulse. Not finding any more aggressive plays to make now. The teleport is back up from Haunzer.
Yeah.
It will be in a second impact.
I mean, although you are playing Alistar, Maokai is definitely not a champion that you want to dive. So Adrian just posturing a little bit to get a couple extra hits on that turret. And Team Impulse going to back off.
Game's at an interesting point right now because four turrets on each side are down, so it's a very, very open battlefield, and the dragon had already been taken, so there's no real objectives drawing people together. Basically, any kill would just be a farm punishment tool. But at the time, since upgraded yellow trinkets have been completed and there's double sight stone on the side of gravity, most of these plays are spotted out and teams are able to farm pretty safely right now.
Yeah, I think if a team is going to make a play here in the mid game, it has to be Team Impulse. They're the ones with the Sivir. They can catch you out while you're trying to move between secondary turrets here. The map is very wide open. And Impact is itching to use his ultimate. Plus, they have Evelyn flanks that are a possibility. You can come in with the submarine type, invisible Shen ultimate piggybacking in.
Yeah.
So Gravity do have to be fairly careful about warding their flanks with pink wards and trying to keep true side up. You know, upgraded sweepers are actually not that great. Pink wards lying around are much better alert system.
See if they can keep that vision up then. Of course, they're still rocking the double sight stone as you expect. Rush, unsurprisingly, not buying one himself. He's got damage to deal. But he does have upgraded trinkets and already improvement over Xiao Wei Xiao. Gate has one too.
And Gate has Death Cap, Morel, and Omicron, full damage even before boots. And Azir is one of the fastest Baron killers into the game. This is a really aggressive move, but it could very well pull off. They're going to be able to burst this Baron down most likely.
Gravity knows, but they might not be here in time. But if he puts the ward down, Sheldon comes in to say hello to Altec. Impact will not quite be in range, but Haunzer is here. He's going to tank up at the front line. Gate is safe so far.
Shockwave?
Oh, good flash by Apollo. Gets away from the Shockwave. Adrian forced right away. His ulti was down. Used it on the Baron. Moves to on the backside. Throwing in javelins. Oh. Tags Apollo.
Gate.
Haunzer is going to take a lot of damage, and Gate's still alive. The taunt
Gate's
comes
out of
in.
Mana.
Oh, big team fight here for Impulse. Two kills picked up, and the Baron.
They couldn't continue to go aggressive. Keen was out of mana there. They had no more damage, and Move gets...
Could have finished him off if he goes for a flash ultimate, but he just holds back and saves his defensive cooldowns for laner. Honestly, Gate is playing quite well this game behind a pretty big carry performance from Rush and Impact, but Gate's doing his job, farming out the mid lane, huge objective presence in his ear, only just the one death, and Team Impulse takes a big jump ahead in this game.
Yeah, look at them murder this Baron. Yes, it does cost Adrian his ultimate to tank the entire thing, and so he'll go down early here, but they're able to get it down in time. Haunzer goes in for the tank.
Yeah, Shockwave hits just on the tanks. Rush pushes off a lot of the damage dealers as well by pushing off Keen, and then because of the duration of this fight that's reset by Bunnyfuku, Keen completely out of mana, that means Tim can just run over the end of it.
Altec stopped trying to hit Adrian. He had him cornered in the Baron Pit with 20 health and like impacted high, and he's like, you're right, I don't want kills, I'm gonna peace out here.
A 23-minute tier was just picked up by Keen. So we'll get into that in a second. So Faker played Orianna.
It was like, I ran out of mana in that last fight.
Yeah. He actually built a Athene's into a Seraph's and then into a Death Cap and a later Void Staff. But Keen is just so far behind on this build. This tier won't complete until at least 35 to 40 minutes, depending on whether he upgrades. And then he would still need to pick up a Death Cap on top of that. This build is turning on way too late for Keen, and an unfortunate, I feel like a poor buy in that case. If he's out of mana, he needs to conserve rather than pick up a tier that will almost never be relevant this match.
Yeah, the entire build there, Keen's into Void, very cheap from Keen.
And it's super defensive as well. He picked up Merc Treads early as well once Rush started getting ahead.
And very mana heavy. Rush here on the outside, gets a double ultimate.
Brings move to half HP, who misses a jump over the wall, goodbye! Kill goes to Apollo, and Team Impulse looking to extend that winning streak to 8. They may have that perfect run to the back half of the split, looking great against Gravity here, the number one team right now in the standings.
Yeah, we Rush may. Doing his job on even. Move, just a very poor misjump there.
Well, I mean,
super thick wall.
That wall is so thick, you can't even get over it.
I think you can as Nidalee.
That's a not, yeah, you can't.
He tried.
I mean, it's not. But, okay, so he tried. Do you classify it as a failed jump just for trying it?
Yep.
Okay.
If you try to jump over the Grand Canyon and fall, it's still a failed jump.
Dang. I guess you're right there.
What if you knew it wasn't going to work, though?
Still a failed jump.
All right.
Holy. All right.
That's fair. Well, 5-kill lead. Team Impulse didn't make their way all the way into the base. They've still got a sizable lead for themselves. Baron buff is timed out by this point.
And if you notice, there's a blue buff on Impact right there. He actually stole it from Keen while Keen was trying to solo that. So.
Well, luckily for Keen, he's got Athene's and a tier. So it's just, yeah. And he's out of mana anyway. Wow.
He's got like 10 mana regen per second, though. It's like...
Currently, I feel like he's going to be able to fight really 107 well. of 750. It's not going to be completing anytime soon.
Big story, though, is definitely Rush. People were wondering what he would go to after the Lee Sin and Nidalee were taken out. His Evelynn has been fantastic, especially on this patch. She really, really thrives in the early game, and he's been able to bring not only the early pressure, but also two auras for his team. So he brings a lot to the mid and late game. For the Team Impulse squad as well. Love the Frozen Heart on her. It was even a main purchase for solo lane Evelynn's last year when it was popular. Because how effective cooldown reduction is on a champion when you're constantly casting your spell. If you play Evelynn and you smash your Q key on cooldown.
Yeah, you're doing it right.
You're making it, that much more effective.
Ideally with a very loud, clackety mechanical keyboard.
What switches?
Right near your coworkers.
What switches do you prefer?
Oh, I don't play mechanical keyboards.
Okay.
I just have coworkers who play Evelynn, and I'm very aware of it. Kobe.
Guilty.
Kobe.
Yeah, Crush. Honestly, I'm also, even though his scoreline is not that impressive, I am impressed by Gate stepping straight into a mid lane, high pressure situation. He had been spamming support so we could play that role for Team Impulse, which is right back to mid lane. And then Keen, who's been one of the higher performing mid laners in the North American LCS, he splits farm with him, maybe even goes ahead, and stays safe on his ear. He's doing exactly what Team Impulse needs him to do. The aggressive plays are happening from Impact and Rush.
Yeah, and those dives are working. I mean, Rush, 9 out of his team's 10 kills. Heck, he's got more than half himself. Definitely working well on the aggressive into tank Evelynn build. That's fine, and he supplants the Sightstone with the Warding Totem upgrade, so... Even Impulse's vision is doing fine. Gravity, 6,000 gold down. Definitely the work cut out for them. A 6K gold lead at 28 minutes. Definitely a sizable one, but Bunny's come back from worse, I believe.
Yeah, I think that the next... Oh, move gets caught.
He's got... No, jump this wall.
Got a flash.
Oh, Rush! Flash the chase, takes a penalty, but he's still very alone by himself. Cannot quite kill off Altec. Impact gets the taunt. Goodbye, Bunny Foo Foo. Turns that one around pretty cleanly, and suddenly they've got Haunter in the middle of their team. Maybe he doesn't want to be here. Bit of damage on a Rush, a nice top flash, a big shockwave though, and maybe it works out. Move picks up one, still pushed around. Then a couple of kills still coming through. Keen trying to make it happen, gets the shutdown, traded back by Gate. Impact still in this fight, cannot kill off Altec himself, but Gate can maybe help that one happen here. Haunter forced to recall. Impact wants to do it. Flash E, auto attack, solo kill for Impact, takes down Altec.
These extended fights where everybody gets their hands dirty. Very exciting to watch. And I was going to start prepping for the next Baron that was going to come up, but now everybody's dead. So basically, you just want to try and clear out some vision and wait till everyone respawns to get back there in time. Team Impulse should be able to arrive and take advantage of their troop site that's been set up.
Yeah, and one thing that's evident in these team fights is neither team is really willing to back down right at the very start of this one. Like, Move ends up going in, and when Rush follows and realizes he's being collapsed on, he doesn't try and run away. He gets ulted on by Impact and just keeps going, and that pattern is followed by Haunter TPing in behind the fight to make sure everything happens. Like, it's all teams just wanting to continue the fight.
Yeah, and these are why we always highlight the importance of the Sivir picks and the global teleports for Team Impulse. You can see there, Apollo and Impact are both able to collapse from across the map using the Sivir speed and the Shen teleport. Gate only arrives now, finally, able to clean up some extra kills here. But the cross map plays here from Impulse continue.
Ooh, ulti to two-man slow. Sivir ulti pops, and they're going to catch out Haunter yet again. The tank Maokai, two-man shockwave, and Haunter's still alive, running away. Headbutt comes in, a two-man toss,
huge.
And there's a double kill. Massive Azir combo coming across, and now Haunter caught out. A triple kill for Gate, his first game in the mid lane, looking for his fourth. Rush takes the kill off here. Bunny Hoover, the only man alive. Baron's back up as well. That's going to go to Impulse.
Yeah, during the replay, it was Team Impulse setting up Vision and just running after for a catch again with the Sivir ultimate. Highly important spell for Team Impulse. They get a group fight. The Ori kept the Maokai alive for long enough, but then it was Gate's turn to shine with the very high damage Azir pick. This is really going to Team Impulse's favor. They're going to look to tie for first place here.
Yep, a very important team fight victory right there, as the neutral objectives are key in Team Impulse taking down these turrets. Gate's able to get the mid lane there. The door is open into the gravity base as they return to purchase. Impact's going to go grab the wave, and they're not going to slow down. He still has his ultimate and teleport available.
Yeah. Really slick shot calling by Team Impulse. They let Gate stay mid while Baron was going down. They knew he could get the turret. They sent everyone top lane knowing they could get that in time as well, and this should be a pretty clean escape. Nicely done by Impulse. Massive lead now. 12,000 almost.
Now, is Rush going to go for a third aura for the team, or is that going to be a selfish magic resist item?
I feel like it should be the Aegis.
Because he's playing... Uh-oh. This is a replay.
Aura body. Yeah, this was.
Let's just watch Impact here, because I see this the taunt to set this up. He just walks straight into their face.
Yep. Gets them both, and then all the Azir shoulders that had been prepped before that fight jump in. Nice alt at the end to back them off. And yeah, it looked like they're going to be chaining this for a triple or a quadra. Keen with a really late flash away as well, unable to escape.
And who would have saw this one coming? I mean, with Shadow Wind, sure, you think there's a chance Impulse keeps the run going, but as you mentioned, the big carry points from Gate, carry from Rush and Gate doing his job, it's Impulse looking at their eighth.
Yeah, obviously time is going to tell here, but I mean, even last week, it seemed like Gravity had kind of lost their aura. They had two very difficult games, lost one of them, and then for Team Impulse, the fact that they actually had a mid laner on a roster, and even though Shao can excel individually, he's not the type who is really cooperative in the team strategy during the game. He generally seems to do his own thing. So plug and play a mid laner for Team Impulse. They can maintain their style. And as long as Gate doesn't choke, maybe they can actually hold this together. This is just one game. Obviously, the story will continue to develop. But that's what's happened in this game.
Well, of course it is. And right now, though, if Impulse does steal this one out, we have a four-way tie for first, I do believe.
Oh, yeah. Things get real exciting now. Everyone is expecting Impulse to fall off.
Strange spectator bug right there. The health bar for the inhibitor wasn't showing up, but they just finish it off, so it doesn't matter at this point. Rush going to look for a flank engage while they engage this next inhibitor. Expect Alistar to tank the turret and Rush to come in behind them.
see if that happens, or if Gravity even tries to fight this one. Knockups come through, and they just run away. Move still taking some damage. There's the hard dive. Bunny Foo Foo goes down. Can't flash or ulti away. I'll take the next target. Going to be drops on this one. Hanser only so tanky. Zero knocks him into the wall. Couple more kills picked up for everybody, and this is going to be probably the game-winning push.
Or just expect everyone on Team Impulse to run straight at them and kill everyone.
Look how hard it is to land an Orianna ult on this team, because Impulse are all just rushing for it in different avenues, and he's only able to get Alistar there. Impulse with a great victory over Team Gravity, 33, 34 minutes in.
Wow. Impressive stuff. And Gate undefeated on Team Impulse, once as a support, once as a mid laner. And the Nidalee first pick does not pay off here for a move. Rush playing a great game, 9-3 and 10.
Super impressive performance right there.
9-3 and 10, and he built for the team as well. He got three aura items, and he has the most kills.
Yeah.
And highest kill participation as well.
He's got the most gold in the game as well, man.
He's got everything.
He's literally the best at everything except for deaths. Well, no, he's got the most deaths. That counts, right?
Yeah, Adrian had another great performance on Alistar, honestly. It did kind of feel like the Rush and Impact show for the most part. Every time Rush was making a big play, he was just more threatening, because I'd say pretty much every Shen ult that game was used right onto Rush.
Yeah, it looked like it. And both of them, 19 out of 22 kill participation. Those guys were absolutely everywhere. It was an absolute great game by these guys.
And it's such a huge win, too. Yeah. This is the number one team they just took down. They're now at 12-4, so there is a three-way tie at the four-way tie at the top?
Yeah,
Team
12,
Liquid,
12 and 5
CLG,
for all these guys.
Gravity, and Team Impulse are all sitting at 12-4, so that bye is completely open now.
Yeah, both
as
of them are.
As far as teams at 12 wins.
Yeah, 12 wins, 5 losses, one game still to play. And keep in mind, Impulse plays Liquid next time, so we won't end in a four-way tie for first. That's impossible. But it's going to be all kinds of intense here. It's at the very end of it all. I mean, Europe had some tiebreakers. They had one, and they had some that were broken by head-to-heads. But this is going to be
for many more.
It's going to be all kinds of fun.